Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Peace be upon you. Welcome to Aspires TV and Barke Bionero show. Today is our second day and second episode. Today is all about scaling. It's all about, we're going in depth of what we've talked about in the first episode that was about living in a box. Now, I'm not going to summarize very quickly because we have so much going on today. So if you want to go back to the first episode and look at it, watch it and see how you can help yourself, and that's amazing, and then come back to the second one. So the second one is about scaling. How are we going to scale our lives? Okay, because we talked about inside the box. How do you get your belief system? How do you get your experiences and things that your life that you've been living? Now, I do this with my clients, okay? This is the first thing I do. It's called a wheel of life. Now, a wheel of life has how many? Let's say some people goes to 8, other people goes to as much as you can go to, because it's how clear you want it for your life, okay? So you use this as I make it into a fun exercise. Now, you can draw your own circle and you can put the major things, okay? Like spiritual is a major one, so you can put that one. You can put relationships, home environment, health, physical activity. You can put education or together, education, career, your finances. You can put that. So you can put only like up to 5, okay? But I would like to put more because then we have more to talk about. Now, the fun thing about this game is that in every part of your life, you have to scale it. So you can put at the bottom if you don't really pay attention to it. And you can put in the middle because you are working on it. You can put it on the top if you actually great at it and you're doing it amazingly. So most of the time when I do this, and I do this either with my one-to-one or I do in a group session, and most of the time, most of everyone, even myself, are to say, I cannot create the whole wheel. Okay, there's some places or some areas in this wheel that are flat, and those areas that needs to be handled. So do this exercise, actually help yourself and see what areas that you need to work on yourself. Now, this is only part of it. Okay, this is just to see where in your area that needs to be looked at. But I also want to talk about basic human needs. Okay, now I don't know if you ever heard of Maslow hierarchy one, so you're gonna enjoy my my creativity. See, part of the wheel of life, there is creativity. Where is it? Over there. So it's going good. So the Maslow one, okay, Maslow put it, well, only five human basic needs, yeah? He put self-actualization, that is the highest, that's the first thing. And then he put self-esteem, okay? Our esteem is very important, so he put it as a second bit. He put it love and belonging as a third one, and fourth as a safety, and the last thing as physiological. Now, you can say to yourself, oh, maybe it's not. But I want you to really go deeper and ask yourself, is it or is it not? Can you start with the self or you start with the physiology? Because this is very important for every human being to know what is their most important basic human need. Now, that is only one part. There's plenty of it. Now, I also found, I know I'm talking too fast, yeah, but there's a lot going on, I know. But there's also fundamental human needs. These are 7 fundamental human needs that are needed. That's what's important, okay? Now, it's all up to you, okay? What do you want for your growth? Because do you want to grow and become a better person? Or do you like where you are right now? If you like where you are right now, this is not for you. For people who wants to make a difference in their lives, who wants to see and to create something for themselves, this is the basic This is the most important thing they need to start on. Now, fundamental human needs, okay? We've got number one, subsistence. Okay, this one for safety. Now, totally different from the Abraham Maslow. Now, the second one is understanding and growth. The third one we've got is connection and love. And the fourth one is contribution. And the fifth one, esteem and identity. The sixth one is self-governance. And this is your freedom and your determination, self-determination, things like that. And the seventh is significance and purpose. Now, we can come out from one side to another, or we can choose what is important to us right now. Now, all of these are scaling. All of these are looking what areas of your life that needs, or what areas of your life that you need to actually look upon and make a difference in your life. So today we've just gone through scaling. We're going through what exactly or what area you need to focus on. And I would love to also share the last thing before I close. He who has a why to live can bear almost any how. That the person who wrote this quote is Frederick Netsiek. I hope I said it right. Anyway, I wish you all the best, and I will see you soon. Take care, everybody. Bye-bye.